On the 19th of July, 2024, the largest IT outage in history happened. American cybersecurity firm called CrowdStrike released a flawed update to its Falcon Sensor security software. This update led to significant issues for Microsoft Windows computers running the software. Approximately 8.5 million systems actually crashed and could not be restarted properly. The outage put a standstill in airports, disrupted businesses, and even caused someone to go missing. And this is not going to be how the CrowdStrike fault happened, because there's a lot of content covering that. This is going to be about how the company CrowdStrike made a series of bad decisions, rookie errors, which led to an outage that's now been labeled as historic. So CrowdStrike released a blog post which summarized the event. On the 19th of July, CrowdStrike, which is a cybersecurity company, released an update to their Falcon Sensor software. And this update accidentally caused problems for Windows computers. CrowdStrike's Falcon Sensor is a piece of cybersecurity software that is designed to protect computers and networks from any threats. It does provide real-time updates, meaning that it can actually detect and respond to threats as they happen rather than waiting for a normal scheduled scan. So this update to the Falcon Sensor was actually supposed to improve security by detecting any new types of threats. CrowdStrike's Falcon Sensor actually gets updated in two ways. You get regular updates. So these are new features, and these updates actually include extensive testing and are rolled out gradually just to ensure that they work correctly. But interestingly, you also get something called rapid updates from CrowdStrike. So these updates are there to actually quickly respond to any new threats that are introduced to the environment. Hence, they can just be deployed faster. And the update that caused the issue was part of a rapid update. So the specific update actually contained a mistake that wasn't caught during testing. Their software, the Falcon Sensor, actually hooks into the Microsoft OS as part of a Windows kernel process. And this process generally has high security privileges. What happens is that Falcon can monitor operations in real time across the entire system. The update had some sort of logic flaw which caused the crash. And because it was tightly linked to the Windows kernel, it resulted in a complete system crash for Windows computers, aka the blue screen of death. It looks like Windows was the only operating system that was affected. The other thing to note was that the fix of this was a bit difficult. So users couldn't delete this faulty file just by going through the normal means, i.e. right-click and delete it on your file extension manager. They couldn't do that because they actually couldn't get into Windows. So what happens is that you actually had to enable safe mode and delete the files. So non-technical users had a problem with this. But also, the actual Falcon Sensor software was installed in a lot of corporate computers or work computers and no personal computers. And unfortunately, a lot of users don't actually have high security privileges on their work computer. So they, in fact, could not delete any secured system files. If you do want to know a bit more about what the fault was and how it happened, I'll link a video in the description. But the damage done was really historic. Microsoft said about 8.5 million devices were affected. And the problem was these devices were all corporate computers, and chances are that they were running critical operations. Airlines were affected, including Delta, United, international airlines as well, like KLM, and even airports. These airlines were actually forced to cancel hundreds of flights until the systems were restored. Public transport was affected in the US. Hospitals as well couldn't access their appointment and administration systems. Financial services were affected. The crash was nothing short of monumental. And you just got to ask the question, in this day and age, and a company as big as CrowdStrike, how on earth did this happen? One of the main critiques that CrowdStrike got was, how did CrowdStrike not find this bug during testing? So in the software world, testing is a big thing and just part of the process of developing and releasing software. Testing is important because it's just a way to guarantee that the software you push out to your clients will actually work and not have any bugs. And the testing process is well-defined in software development. There are many ways to test your software. So here's an example. There's unit testing. So unit testing checks the individual components of the changes that you've made and make sure that it's all okay. You then get something like integration testing, which ensures just different parts of the software actually work together with the new change. There's also system testing, which tests entire different software systems as a whole with the new changes that you've made. There's also user testing, where you get actual real users to test the changes. And what I'm saying here is that thorough testing must be done in the software development process. This isn't some sort of new method or some sort of new phase that's been added. It's always been there. Everyone knows that it is important. Additionally, you can have different deployment strategies. So you do not have to release the new changes to your customers all at once. A staggered deployment can be used as well, where the software is gradually rolled out to users in phases and it addresses any of the issues before a full-blown release. So what I'm trying to say here is that testing is a thing that is always done in the software development process, or that a lot of companies know that it needs to be done, and it needs to be done properly, regardless of what you're pushing out. CrowdStrike kept on saying that the issue there was a faulty file. That was the problem. That was the one mistake. But actually, this wasn't just one mistake they made. It was a series of mistakes. Interestingly, CrowdStrike actually released a post-analysis article which details the issues that they had. And from this post, what they indicate is on the 19th of July, 2024, an update with a mistake slipped through the cracks. The issue happened within something called the content validator, which is a tool that actually checks for issues in updates. And due to a bug, it approved the update that contained the problematic file. And when the update was installed, it caused the computer to crash. And it does look like this content validate tool is the last check that is done before an update can be pushed to deployment. And it looks like this content validator tool is an automated tool, which is really interesting to me because doesn't mean that it wasn't physically tested in a testing environment by actual humans. And an automated tool being the main check before something is released is quite a risk that you're taking. Keep implying that the update was minor, but the problem is that their clientele is huge and that their product is about cybersecurity. So there is a huge risk there. So is it not important to have an actual human QA team give the go-ahead for any kind of updates? They don't really indicate that there was some sort of human QA team which went through the release and tested it. In the article, they do say that they will start using local developer testing, content update and rollback testing, the normal testing processes. Again, they don't really say that they've done that before and are looking to improve it. It almost seems like they are just starting to do that. And also, if you look at this section, look at what they're saying that they will do in future, which essentially means that they haven't done it in the past. And you just want to ask the question, well, why haven't you actually done it in the past until a big mistake like this occurred? Number one is they want to implement a staggered deployment strategy. Again, interesting that they haven't done this before, especially with a high-risk product like theirs. Number two is allowing customers to select when and where these updates are deployed. Again, was this not an option before? Because in any big software that you use, usually you do have that option of actually scheduling your updates or deciding, you know, what to be installed. Number three is also interesting. Provide content update details via release notes. The fact that they did not do this before, and I'm not a CrowdStrike customer, so if someone can just confirm, did they not provide any release notes when they send through updates? Because even scammy apps on the Play Store made by one developer gets release notes. It's also very surprising that they don't send release notes when they release any sort of update. The other thing, which is also a really rookie error, is that this was deployed on a Friday, which again, in software development, it's generally a big no-no. You don't want to deploy on a Friday because if things go wrong, it's going to go wrong on the weekend. So there's a few mistakes they made, and a lot of people are asking, why were these even mistakes? They do imply that they use a lot of automated testing in their comms. And again, they didn't really indicate anything about a human QA team or QA department. They also didn't do a staggered deployment. All of this is just pointing to the fact that they were rushing the update and taking a bunch of shortcuts. And it just leads to one common theme. It looks like they are trying to cut costs. Firstly, testing and QA takes time, and it's not something that can be instantly done. A lot of businesses know that, and that's why a lot of businesses don't like the testing process, because it actually pushes back the release date. And I guess a company like CrowdStrike, they want to be a trailblazer. They want to give everybody security, which is constantly updated. But the more updates, the more testing, the more time it takes, the more money it consumes. So that could be a reason why their testing process is automated and not very thorough. I also couldn't find any documentation or anything that implied them having an in-house human QA team. They may have an outsourced team, but one would say for a cybersecurity company, you would want an in-house human QA team that is quite beefy, that's quite big. And again, through all of their comms, still no way of telling the depth of their QA team, if they even have one. Do they even do any manual testing process? There have also been rumors about layoffs and outsourcing the QA, which is obviously another cost-cutting method. I can't find anything substantial or official documentation on layoffs from CrowdStrike. However, having a look at Glassdoor, lots of reviews mention layoffs, but still nothing actually confirming this. A lot of reviews are also hating on a specific department in CrowdStrike. Essentially, they're saying that this department is not inclusive, it's aggressive, it's immature. They're referring to the senior leadership. And to be honest, this whole big historic outage should be blamed on one person, this guy. So George Kurtz is the CEO of CrowdStrike. He actually used to be the chief technology officer of McAfee. And interestingly, in his watch, on April 21st, 2010, McAfee released an update to its software used by its corporate customers. The update deleted a Windows file, causing millions of computers around the world to crash and repeatedly reboot. It does sound a bit too similar. And when the media asked CrowdStrike about it, a spokesperson said, George was there as a sales-facing CTO, not in charge of engineering, technology, or operations. Because generally, a chief in technology is just there for sales. But the point is that a mistake on this level is a CEO issue. This is a senior leadership issue. They clearly didn't focus on quality testing, and this is a decision that's always made from the top. I find his official statement on Twitter to be quite matter of fact. He doesn't seem like a person who acknowledges the depth of the mistake, which I guess they are worried about the future of CrowdStrike and the outlook. But it does seem like he doesn't make the best decisions. So they decided that they'll try to make their customers happy. So they send off a newsletter about the issue and then offer an apology gift, which was a $10 Uber Eats gift card. Weird decision. Can you even buy anything for $10 in the States? I mean, I'm from South Africa, so yes, we can. Food is quite cheap here, but can you even buy anything worth $10 in the States? With delivery? Like, was that really needed? And honestly, anyone, even if you don't have any senior leadership experience, would know that this was a bad idea. Also, apparently it just didn't work properly, so there's that. That being said, I think it's important to think about when issues like this happen at this scale. You can't really blame a developer making $80,000 to $100,000 a year on this mistake, who's working day and night, doing 100 different tasks, not getting enough support. You can't blame it on your workforce, because this issue here is clearly a decision or a series of bad decisions that have been made from the top. And if there's one person that needs to go, it should be this guy. That being said, it does look like CrowdStrike might be sued by its shareholders. Bigger clients are not happy with CrowdStrike as well. There's a few articles coming out about Delta. I guess it also opens a discussion of, you know, a big security risk. If a company like CrowdStrike owns the monopoly when it comes to cybersecurity, if it goes down, it really causes a huge avalanche. But I think it's a good lesson for any company wanting to cut corners to save costs. It never works. Eventually, it will come back to bite you. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my content, please like, comment, and subscribe. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.